Hello and welcome to my shop. I don't know if you remember my coffee table from one of the first videos. That's the one right here. So over the Christmas break, my dad came over from France and we finally got to fix the coffee table. Let's play some reminders from last one to see what was the deal with it.
This one went also crazy in terms of wood movement. And you'll see later what I'm talking about. This one actually split in half, almost in half, at one of the glue joints. Probably because the wood dried in my house and the glass didn't give, so it split the table open. To come back on the split I mentioned earlier, we'll show you pictures up here. And worth mentioning that also my puppy dog decided to chew on the furniture, so now I got chew marks, which you can also see up here. So now I need to either fix it or build me another one. I don't know which yet. For this, I'm waiting for my dad to come back to the US so we can do it together, because he helped me build the table in the first place. So I'd like to either fix it or build a new table also with him.
So as you saw, the table split in half. So we had to fix that. The dog chewed on it. We had to fix that. We had two choices, really. Try to fix it or build another one. And we decided to try to fix it. If the end result isn't good, I'll build another one. But let's see what we can come up with. I did not record the part where I was with my dad because he didn't want to be on videos. But let's take it from there. And so pretty much where we left off when we flew with him two friends for the Christmas break.
So if you remember, he was chewed around here. And they're on here somewhere or here somewhere. I don't remember exactly where. So we had to take this piece out and another piece over here out. And we need to make sure it's matching on the other side. So what did we do? So you can see barely in here. This we cut just before the seam here, here and here. Try to maintain full width of those. And it was awkward to cut with a track saw, so it didn't work too good. But we made it. So you see here, these three are different. So this is something we have redone. So two cuts, and the two cuts are important because every time you cut, you lose an eighth of an inch. So if you place incorrectly your cuts, you may have a problem, and that's maybe something we kind of overlooked a little bit. We'll see later. So only two cuts. These three pieces here are new, and this bar right here is new. Everything else is the same. If we go back to the other side, it was a bit more difficult over here, so we had to cut at least the same thing, but actually more. And if you see here, you can see it better from here. So this one's the same as the other side. It's new all the way up to here, which is right here. So we had to go further down because of the dog marks too. So this is two cuts also, so we lose the same eighth of an inch if we don't pay attention. Normally, if you do correctly, if you sew right next to the line here and here, you should, by putting the new ones in, you should be
at the same dimension. It shouldn't be a problem. Yeah. On this side, we have to do another two cuts. And you see here from here all the way to here is new. So we put a new block here. That's two more cuts. So another quarter inch here. So if you don't pay attention, you potentially lose what, half an inch over the width of a table. Then what else do we have to do? When I first started, I created this groove with a router, but I had never used a router before, so the groove wasn't done too good. So I redid this groove based on the top itself. So it's not perfect because I had to use the edge here as a guide, but it is a lot better than it used to be. And I also redid here, I extended a little bit, as you can see here, there's a lip which we didn't have before. I extended here for expansion, even though in this direction it should not go because the fibers are all in this direction. So if it's gonna expand, it's gonna expand this way, which I increased also by a quarter inch on each side. So what I need to do is do a final sanding everywhere, ease the edges, and then we're gonna put another pre-stain thing because it's pine, and so even though it was sealed before, I want to make sure at least on the new ones it is sealed. So we'll reseal the entire thing again, and then we'll do whitewash and a clear coat, and it should be finished. So this is a part that I couldn't do when my dad was here and we didn't have time. So let's finish it together and see what it does. If the end result is not satisfying, we'll trash it and build another one. So let's go. To pre-stain the wood, it's pine, I don't want to blotch, and then we're gonna use this for a whitewash and a clear coat on top of that. That's what we're gonna do. in the house. So let's go and do a small walk around to see what it looks like before going in the house. I'm happy with it, so all good. Let's see what it does in the house. Final touch before going in the house, I'm gonna put sticky pads on the corners so I don't scratch my floor in the house. That's the end of it. Then we'll take it to the house and see what it looks like. These are gonna be 2.5 by 2.5. At each corner. Nothing fancy, just 4 2.5 by 2.5 square on each corner. Here it is, back in place with the glass on. I think it looks good. I did increase the gap between the glass and the table to avoid splitting again. I may have gone overboard. I did I think a quarter inch on both sides, and the gap is big, so might be too big. And I also increased on both sides there and there. I should probably have also done less, but it is what it is. It looks pretty good, so I'm happy with it until I make something else. Something else also, you may have remembered at the beginning of a video that I mentioned the cuts were important, and if you didn't pay attention, you could have issues. So if you look here, and you can see it from your eyes, the table is 40 1/4 on that side. And 40 5/8 on the other side. The main reason being, not only the cuts, but when I did the new pieces, I went and make sure the seams were all perfect, and for this I put the 2x4s through the jointer to have a flat surface for glue up. And even though I reduced the thickness of each pass, it took some. So the table is not rectangular anymore. It looks, you can't see it because it's over, it's over 63 inches. So the difference of 3/8, you can't see over 63 inches, but I know it's there. I know it's not rectangular and it bothers the crap out of me, but that's good enough. So thank you all for tuning in, and I'll catch you in the next one.